I thought it was about time to do a couple more upgrades on my homemade little track cleaning car here. Stuff that'll make it run a little bit better in a train. Right now it does its job cleaning, but I am going to today upgrade the wheels, because these are just the original cheap plastic train set wheels that are in there. And I'm going to upgrade the couplers. I put a Kadee coupler on this end already, just so that I could actually test it out and use it. This one's still got the horn hook. But I don't generally like using truck-mounted couplers. I prefer them to be body-mounted, because, especially when you're backing up, it allows it to back up nice and straight properly, and it doesn't put sideways forces on it and force it to, or make it derail easier. So that's the two things that I'm going to do today. For the wheels, I'm going to use metal wheels. I mean, there's a few different brands that you can get. I'm going to use these Proto 2000. Notice it still says lifelike, because that's who invented Proto 2000 way back before they got bought out. I've had these in stock, like everything else around here, for years and years. So when I bought them, it was, $9.20 for four cars worth. So basically, $3 and change per car. You can get them in different sizes, 33-inch prototype and 36-inch prototype. I measured these earlier, and the 33s are closer to what's on here for size. So that's the ones I'm going to use. And that's just, this is literally the easiest thing you can do. You just pop those guys out and toss them into your random box of wheels. You just, where's my little screwdriver? Maybe it's easier to see. You just literally pry the side frame just ever so slightly sideways, just until the wheel pops out. It doesn't take much of a bend at all. You don't want to break it, but it doesn't take very much of a bend at all. Just that much. And you even do it with your thumbnail, it's even easier. And there it is. Now then, put those in, it's just the reverse of taking them out. Just put one end in, give it a little bit of a spread, and there it is. Ding. Two. There they go. Nice easy runners. This is a lot easier when I'm not trying to show the camera everything is, apparently. One of the things I'm learning about doing these videos. There we go. Poof. In. Done. Nice, smooth running. The advantages of metal wheels, they're a little bit heavier, so you get a bit more traction weight. They sound better. They roll smoother. They don't pick up crud off the track. Oh, good. There's wheels all over the ground. And look at that, that's just super smooth. That was easy. And like I said, $3. The car rolls better, it's not going to pick up crud off the track. Especially for the track cleaning car, that's important that you're not picking up crud onto the wheels and redistributing it around as much. Now to the couplers. So this one, the horn hook couplers, are just screwed onto a little mounting box on the truck. And actually, I'm going to pop these off. Some are screwed in from the bottom. These ones are just a little friction fit clip, so literally just grab them and pull them off. Probably saw that earlier when I installed the thing in the first place. So, like I said, that original horn hook, it just comes off with a tiny little screw, which I didn't lose, surprisingly. And there it is. So if you wanted to, you can put just put Kadees on. This one I didn't put on properly. I just used the existing draft gearbox that was on the truck, and I added a Kadee lid to a coupler box lid to it, and then put the number 5 coupler in there. It fit loose. That wasn't intended as a permanent installation. You could, if you wanted to keep using these, you could shave the lips off the side of them and use the screw hole that was already there, and bolt on a Kadee coupler with its draft gearbox. Just bolt it right on in place of that, just thinning the piece down until it works, and that would work. But like I said, I prefer body mounting the couplers. So I'm going to take a draft gearbox like that, and I am going to where's that? That metal plate ends short of here, I remember, when we took it apart. So I might just drill and tap that and stick it right into there. Depending on the height that I need, and there is actually a lip there, so I probably will have to. I'll build that up with some squares of styrene, glue it on, and then screw right through it. Or if this needs to sit a little bit higher, which I don't think it will, I can cut some of that lip away. But first things first, I'm going to cut off this draft gearbox left over from the horn hooks. I'll just pop that wheel out of there again that I just put in and decide how I'm going to take that off. This is out of my X-Acto blade assortment. This is just a little X-Acto saw blade, and it fits down in there nicely. There. So there's the horn hook gearbox, and I've still got a little bit of cleaning up in there, but it's not nearly as bad as it was going to be. Okay, so there's the piece that I cut off. There's where it came off. I've still got a little sharp lip there that I have to get rid of, and there's what it looked like before. Make it nice and flush so that it doesn't interfere with the underside of the car. There it is. Okay, now then, I'll repeat that on the other one, but you don't have to watch that because you've seen it once. Before I decide to put that Kadee coupler on there in the coupler box, I should just, there's another one that I've pre-made. I should just go through putting one of these together for you. So as it comes, you get them, they come either 4 in an envelope or 10. I bought the bulk pack. So it comes with, where is it here, a sprue of coupler box lids and boxes. It comes with couplers, and it comes with a coupler spring which goes in the box. And how these go together, knock a box and a lid off the sprue. I'll clean that up later. but the lid or the this is the lid. It has a little center boss on there, and the box itself is recessed, so you just set the spring into there, set the coupler in, and put the box on top so that it all goes through, and it just clicks into place. Now, it's not held all that solidly. It's just a press fit. So you either have to glue it together, like I did for this one, or bolt it, like I did for this one. For mounting it, you have a few options. You can glue it. Well, that doesn't allow for adjusting. You can bolt it into the bottom of a car, which is why I've got that one set up like that. Either you can bolt it through the center, or if you have small enough hardware, you can bolt it through these two little holes in the side here. The next step for putting the couplers on is to decide how high you want them. As I said earlier, we may or may not want some spacing here, but that's where the Kadee coupler gauge comes in. It's used specifically for adjusting couplers. I guess we're going to need the trucks again, aren't we? So this one, that's why I've got this one glued together here, just to use as a gauge. But I'll put it at different heights here and just test fit it against there until I'm convinced I'm at the right height. Okay, I'm not sure if you can see this, but I'll try it anyway. So with the coupler lined up with the gauge, notice it has to be sitting well below the car. My options are build up the area under the car, but that's quite a distance to build it up, and that'll be pretty obvious. My other option is to lower the car body a little bit. And as you notice, there's a fair bit of room between the trucks and the bottom of the car. So I think I could actually lower the car body almost enough to make that happen. So I'm going to try that. Of course, I have to lower it the same amount on both ends, which is going to be another trick. So I can measure the depth of it just using the end of my caliper, and they're both the same right now. What I did is with one hand, not the tweezers, but with one hand, I just held this up level. Then I got down with my eyes and eyeballed the gap to the bottom of the car there. And that is pretty much 3 millimeters bang on. So I've got to bring it down approximately 3.5 millimeters. Okay, can I get 3.5 millimeters out of these bosses? No, I can go down some, but I don't think I can go down full 3.5 millimeters. So I'm just going to file it down as far as I think is safe. I'm going to file one end at a time and then measure it and make the other one match. And I'm not going to use my small gentle files. I'm going to use my big Nicholson Home and Garden file here. And I'm going to hold that level. Matter of fact, stand by. So, let's put a little level on there. I've checked my bench is close enough to level for this. And I will just make sure that I keep that fairly level. And take off a nice even amount off the bottom of that truck boss. As I'm filing, I'm going to stop every once in a while and just make sure that the truck's not going to cause a problem crashing on that sander beam. And it looks like I've still got a couple of millimeters that can come down. Back, just clean my file off with a wire brush here. It's not getting clogged up. And carry on. Okay, let's check that again. While I was away, I remembered that I don't have to read the old analog one. I've actually got
a digital caliper.
So I don't have to think. Isn't that awesome? So, that one is 6.6 millimeters, and this one now is 1.6 millimeters less than that, and which is about half of what I thought I was going to have to take off. So let's see how this looks. Okay, that still sits on there, but it's just, if I rock it the one way, it's just crashing on, if I hold it level, it's just missing the center beam there. If I rock it, it crashes into it, but that's not going to do that on the tracks ever. And it still sits flat because I was filing it level. So now then, I'm just going to, well, actually, no. I'll do the same thing on the other end. Back to this again. Okay. Now, both ends are the same height. And the trucks are just barely clearing that center beam on both ends. So that's 1.5 to 2 millimeters that's been taken off there. Ah, get out of there. So that's that. I'm just going to clean up a little bit of the burring in here from the filing, so the truck will swivel nicely. I'll dust that off later. So now, just have to figure out how much I have to shim it up now that I've gone down as far as I can there. All right, the next thing that I've done to determine the height is, I've set this up on the track again. Held that in place in front of the coupler gauge with my hand and held it level and run the car over, and then experimentally just set different thicknesses of bits of plastic on there and eyeballed it from underneath and determined that, just experimentally, no actual measuring, that this little piece which I have more of, out of my accumulation of different sorts and thicknesses of plastic, is the one that I need. And it's something that you probably eventually want to accumulate over time, is just an assortment of thicknesses of plastic from a variety of sources. And even down to these things. And it's free plastic, and it's a different thickness. And even those come in different sizes and thicknesses. So having an accumulation allows you to just experimentally fit just about any situation you might want to, and it costs nothing to hang on to it. So I'm going to cut another square of this, and I'll glue them on. If anything, they're going to be a hair too skinny, and once I've glued them on there, I'm going to position it again and just experimentally check it, and if it is too thin, then I'll add shims of another thin plastic, either this one or something else that I've got. So while I'm waiting for the glue to dry, I've got the screws these are number 2 machine screws, which is the size that'll fit through the hole in the coupler box. And I've found the piece that I cut out of the middle of the bottom of this car. And I've got a scrap off cut of the piece of plastic that I put in there. I'll just measure that thickness. Happens to be about 6.3 millimeters. I'm just going to transfer that onto one of these screws. I'm going to chop that screw off. I've run these nuts on so that once I cut it, I can use them to chase the threads back out again, because cutting it with a saw is pretty much guaranteed to bugger the threads. Nuts should come right off. There's one off. There's the other one off. One last thing that I'm going to do. Turn this into a bit of a self-tapping screw just by cutting a little slot in it with my saw. Just in the first little bit there. Then I'll hit that with the file just to open it up a little bit. Clean that up, and what that'll do is, as it goes through the plastic, it's going to cut a slot or cut a thread for itself into the plastic. Okay, the glue's dried. I prepared a second screw. So now I'll just visually center that coupler, mark the hole. Repeat at the other end. Before I do too much drilling, make a quick depth stop with a piece of tape here, and then I'll get a little bit further into this. Now I can get a bit more aggressive. And there I'm seeing the black plastic coming up, so that's exactly what I wanted. Same again at the other end. My depth stop slid. Oops. Went through. Good thing I'm going to put a load in this car. Okay. Now that that's in and the hole's made, and I've off camera, I chased the threads of the hole just using the screw without the coupler box, just to make it a little bit easier here. I mean, that's threaded into plastic, so it's not going to be completely bulletproof, but now then we can test fit this again. And that's a large part of this, is just test, fit, check, measure, adjust, try again. Am I on the rails? I'm not. There. Would you look at that? That's pretty close. I don't think I want to adjust the height of that anymore. Look at that. So, that went easier than I thought, actually. Now all I have to do is mount the other one, which should be just a complete piece of cake. There you go. Back on. Tried that one too, just in case I screwed up with my truck height filing. Oh. Okay, this is the other thing that Kadee gauge does for you. The coupler height looks pretty good, but you see that little lip down at the bottom there? The trip pin's hitting it. And that is another adjustment that this does. Okay, so that little shelf on the bottom of the coupler gauge, its purpose is to determine the correct height of the trip pin. So in this case, the trip pin is crashing into it, which means the trip pin will also crash into crossovers and turnouts and turnout frogs and grade crossings and anything else. So Kadee sells a tool just for adjusting that. I don't have one. Just get the tip of my pliers on the top of where the trip pin comes through the coupler, and on the bottom of the trip pin. Very gently squeeze it up. The Kadee tool isn't nearly as precarious as that, but there we go. You can see that it slipped over the top and just coupled right on with no headaches or anything. There, done. That took me a couple of hours to do this evening. Hopefully the edit will be a lot shorter and it won't take you a couple hours to watch it. But I have improved the running of this thing and the coupling of it. Those all work. And the car sits just a little bit lower than it did too, a couple of millimeters, so it's not going to look quite as much like it's standing on stilts. All right, thanks for watching.